And was that something that you expect each team player to do on their own, or company would come up with some kind of growth, development, leadership workshops? Would you do something like that, like internally yourself, or you would send them out? How would you deal with this?
I've done it a couple different ways, right? Earlier in my career, slow growth company at Bungie, we weren't growing 100%. Slow growth, you know, we had annual goals for people. And part of the annual goals of every one of my supervisors and managers, they had five places they had to cover, right? One was productivity, safety, quality, right? And then they would have three or four bullet points under each one of those. Then they had personal development, which they had a few things they had to do each year for personal development. It could be reading a book, taking a course, whatever it is, starting college, depending on where they were. And then the last one was team development. So they're actually developing their team under them. So if you got a supervisor, they're developing the people that they're supervising. And they would have specific goals that they had to accomplish by the end of the year. So it's like those five were there. Mm-hmm. When I was at Vital Proteins, we were growing so fast, we didn't have time for that. We didn't even put annual goals. It was like the weekly goal. It was like, you're growing so fast. It was like, there was no way. The only thing we had as an annual goal is what the annual revenue was and in some major capital projects. But we didn't have time for a very detailed development plan.
Yeah.
So we would sit down quarterly and it's, okay, what skills do we need in the plant by the end of this year? So let's say it's June 2024. Okay, by January, what skills are we missing in the plant that we need for our growth for next year? And it could be certain certification, quality certifications. It could be learning different software systems. And then the different managers will go get their people trained in the different areas. We're bringing in a new software system to take us to the next level. How many people do we need to be experts in that software system by the end of the year? And so it was very fast. I would say it was less formal, but in that organization with that culture and those people, it was more effective.
Also, you touched on the software. Would you, like, because you already see, you spoke to a business owner and they told you, we're going to grow, we're going to double every year. That's the vision, right? So when you're looking at the software to support that processes, do you look at the 5-year picture, 3-year picture, 1-year picture? But do you get, like, let's say ARP, do you install it right away because you're going to know that you're going to have that tremendous growth, or you actually wait until the right time comes? Like, do you, how in advance do you start to prepare with the softwares and tools?
Usually at the very beginning, we have it laid out what software systems we need. Let's say the company is going to grow to $100 million. Okay. Mm-hmm. So at $100 million, what are all the software systems we need? And then we sequence the order of when we're going to implement them, right? So every company is going to be different. Some companies need the ERP system right away. Some might need a WMS right away that then layers on top of the ERP when it rolls out. So you pick the and the WMS is a warehouse management system, as you know, and the ERP is the enterprise, which is accounting, but it also sometimes integrates with the WMS. So you're either going to use the WMS within the ERP or roll out a WMS that can integrate with the ERP system that you're going to roll out 2 years from now or a year from now. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Usually it's a revenue. When we hit X revenue, we need to have an ERP implemented. When we hit this amount of shipments in a day, we need to have a WMS integrated with ShipStation and Shopify and stuff like that. So it really depends on the type of company and where their pain points are. And usually it's a revenue or shipment trigger that determines when we got to have different things rolled out. But we usually plan that out like 3 years in advance, what we're rolling out each year.
Mm-hmm. Got it. Okay.